Hey everyone, this is Anam. Welcome to my YouTube channel. In this video, I'm going to discuss the summary of Kathmandu from the book Beehive of Class 9. This chapter is an extract from Vikram Seth's travelogue, Heaven Lake, which narrates his long journey from China to India via Tibet and Nepal. Travelogue means a written account of somebody's travels. This chapter is an account of his time spent in Nepal visiting two temples, the Pashupatinath and the Bodhnath Stupa. The Pashupatinath is a very famous Hindu temple and the Bodhnath Stupa is sacred to the Buddhists. So when he stays in Kathmandu for several days, he visits these two places and then he compares both of them. Firstly, he visits the Pashupatinath temple. When he goes there, he finds out that only Hindus are allowed in this temple. The entry of non-Hindus is banned. There is chaos all around. People are pushing each other, trying to get the priest's attention. Some foreigners are arguing with the policeman, who is not letting them go inside the temple because only Hindus are allowed inside. These foreigners, they are trying to convince him that yes, they are Hindus, but obviously he doesn't believe them and hence he doesn't allow them to go inside. The narrator then notices that a royal princess comes in the temple and gets special treatment. With this incident, we come to know that they did not treat all the people as equals in this temple. VIPs got special treatment. Then he sees that two monkeys are chasing each other and they jump on the Shivling. Dogs are fighting with each other, they are barking. Cattle are moving around. Hawkers shout to sell out their wares. Priests, devotees, hawkers, dogs, cattle, monkeys, tourists all get together to add to the confusion. There is noise all around. There is atmosphere of febrile confusion. Febrile confusion means complete confusion. There was absence of peace. All he could hear was noise. So he didn't feel peaceful at all. He didn't like this place. Then he goes to the Bodhnath Stupa. Before that, he also talks about Bhagmati River, which flows near the temple. He says a cremation is taking place on the bank of the river. Cremation means the last rites, burning of a dead body. Women are washing clothes and children are bathing in it. It is polluted with wilted flowers and old offerings from the temple. So on one hand, they call this river holy, they worship it. And on the other hand, all the dried up flowers and old offerings, all the wastage, the garbage, it is collected from the temple. And since the river flows nearby the temple, all this garbage is discharged into the river, which is quite contradictory. They say they worship it and still they pollute it every day. Then he tells about a shrine on the riverbank. He says that a shrine half protrudes from the stone platform on the riverbank. Half protrudes means it is slightly above the ground and most of the portion is inside the ground. And the people believe that when it emerges fully, when it fully comes out from the ground, the goddess inside will escape and the evil period of Kali Yuga will end. After this, he visits the Bodhnath Stupa and he finds it quite a peaceful place. The atmosphere in and around Bodhnath Stupa is just the opposite of the Pashupatinath temple. As you can see in the picture, it has an immense white dome surrounded by a road. The narrator finds peace and quietness here. Atmosphere is of serenity. Serenity means purity, spirituality. There are small shops of Tibetan migrants near the stupa. But still, there are no crowds. This is a heaven of quietness in the busy streets around. Heaven means home. So he is saying that he found peace here, right? So obviously we come to understand that he liked Bodhnath Stupa and he didn't like Pashupatinath temple because the atmosphere there was of full confusion. Then he talks about the city Kathmandu. He says that the city is vivid and religious. Vivid means bright. Mercenary. Mercenary means primarily focusing on earning money. He finds its narrow and busy streets as very noisy. Radios, traffic car horns, bicycle bells, cows all contribute to the noise. At last, he talks about a fruit seller. A fruit seller standing in a corner near a hotel catches the narrator's attention. He has a casual approach and a distinct style. See, all the other hawkers, they were shouting to sell out their things. But this fruit seller was very calm and composed and he wasn't shouting at all. Every now and then he was playing his flute and then he would just stand quietly. He doesn't shout out loud to sell out his wares and is quite modest. The narrator is mesmerized by the music of his flute. So after listening to the music of his flute, it reminds the narrator of different kinds of flutes. He thinks about their features and uniqueness. He also remarks that flute has a special place in almost every culture in the world. So in almost all the countries, in most of the countries in the world, they have flutes. Obviously, the name is different in each and every country, but a flute-like musical instrument has a special place in every culture in the world. This music leaves a deep imprint on his mind. The narrator is now homesick and returns to his home in India. Obviously, he was traveling for a long time. Now he is missing his home, so he decides to go back to his home. That was the summary of this lesson. If you liked the video, then please subscribe to my channel and hit the bell icon. Thank you.